Thank you. Pastor Darius here. I hope you are well. I hope God is your source, and I hope you are really even now trusting him in everything that you're doing. My prayer is that you utilize him in every area of your life, even today. You probably wonder why I'm saying this. Those who watch me often, it's because those who follow me, I want you to be reminded that God is your source daily. For the ones who just seeing me, I want you to understand that God must be your source. So if this is your first time hearing me, then God, my presentation to you, is wanting him to be your source. All right. That's why I often say that, because a source is uniquely different than a resource. A source is something that you draw into to pull out from always. Okay. Let us pray. Lord, we love you. We give you honor. We give you glory. Thank you for all of your promises and the steps of a good man being ordered by you. Let us know that we have everything we need for real from the Word of God, from Genesis to Revelation, from love stories to murders. We know for sure those that study and those that seek you, there are answers there that's way above we can ever think or imagine, that literally and figuratively not just save our lives to save us, but because you have created a position to save us is where we most value, and the opportunity to know that life can be wonderful with you in it. In Jesus' name, amen. Okay, our Grace Central Outreach, our Grace Central Church, we feed between 200 to 300 people or families every week from 5 till 7. We do it every week. Some just doing it for the holidays. I ain't no hater, but it's just true. But we do it every week, all year long. Tuesdays from 5 till 7. Wednesdays, we do seniors from noon till 2, so they won't be out in the evenings. 8 different townships. And y'all won't be giving no peanut butter and crackers. We give food, $200 to $300 worth of food. When people come, they be like, we love Grace Central Food Pantry. And it's because we care. We really want people to be happy. He that is great among you, let him be a server. Not afraid of it at all. So if you know anybody who need food, especially during these holidays, call us, share with them, us, or share with them where they can come to get dinner boxes with everything in it. We get some good stuff over here. Listen, Linda. Okay, so if you know anybody who's in need of food, please send them our way and let them know that they can really be blessed over here with food, let alone the spiritual aspect of it. Okay. All right. Hey, let's journey through the good news. Hey, when we're going to get to the good part, here it is, right here, the good part. We're going to go to 1 Peter 1 and 10. If you for real, get into the Word of God, it's stuff in there, y'all. Just on GP, like sometimes I study and I don't have a reason to study, but I'll just sit in my office and I'll read, you know, and sometimes I'll think about some things and say, what does God say about this? Of which salvation the prophets have inquired and searched diligently. Who prophesied of the grace that should come unto you. Okay. I want to use for a thought today. It doesn't happen without invitation. It doesn't happen without invitation. Watch this. The Word of God is so clear when we study that we have to study words. And this one in particular says, of which salvation the prophets have inquired and searched diligently. Or whoever you are, which one of you, in context of how you want to see you being saved from some situations, or even being saved from some of the things we put ourselves in. Of which salvation the prophets have inquired, or who are you that's really looking for God's direction? And you search diligently for it. Watch this. Who prophesied of the grace that should come unto you, or God's word, or God's prophet, or God's word, who keep telling you to come here, that if you're really looking for what you're looking for, I have an invitation for you. Come here. Who prophesied of the grace, or grace is time. You guys, grace, when you see this word, so many people don't study the word of God. And that's why I kind of articulate things when I'm sharing on Tuesday. That we understand grace simply means time, T-I-M-E. That's all grace is. So when he says who prophesied of the grace or the timing in our lives, that there's a certain time for everything that should come unto you, or there's an invitation I have for you that's going to come at a certain time. Because sometimes God can be right in our face and we don't hear him. Mm-hmm. Sometimes God can be right in our presence and we don't want him. We want what we have in front of us, which is not bad. But the word of today says, whatever's happening and however we're going to do this, it doesn't happen without invitation. You have to invite God's direction in your life. Watch this. And God has to, once you say, God, I want you, invite you to him. He's not going to bombard you, even though things are good. You ever got paid and you just got, up in the air? Watch this. Even when you get paid, do you know God expects you to be good stewards of what you have, that you're supposed to manage it well? Mm-hmm. Whatever you do, you are supposed to understand God's word to the degree that do whatever you do, but whatever you do, don't put yourself in harm's way by doing that. Because the invitation that God has for us is, I want to show you not necessarily what to do, but how to do it. And I don't want to tell you what to think, but how to think. So that invitation says, hey, you want this? Come here. But if not, he's going to let you and myself just do whatever we want to do. It's a whole lot of people that live their lives outside of God's word. And you also know that there's a lot of people, y'all, check this out. I'm seeing them who are doing things and they're not even happy. They're just doing it. Have you ever seen somebody with something and you know they're not happy, they're miserable? Have you ever seen somebody with something that's good and because they're not really putting God in what they do and have, that they're not happy? That you could see that they just existing. That's right here. You know? Mm-hmm. Because to really have life and it more abundantly God's way, it doesn't happen without an invitation. He has to invite you in this place, and you have to want to be in that place in order for the invitation to happen. Mm-hmm. Yep. And he gives us time. Prayerfully, whatever we're dealing with won't take us out or wear us out before God's happiness, his way, happens. Yeah, because you already know, if you don't, you know by now, stuff will never make you happy. They're conduits and resources. Your happiness comes from a simple foundation of understanding that God has already supplied all of our needs. Yep. So when you understand God's word, it doesn't happen without an invitation. It's not going to happen the way God wants things to happen until you always invite God into your space and place. And once you invite God into your space and place, his invitation is, thank you, come on. Because if you don't invite him into your space and place, he's going to let you stay right where you are. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So friends, confirm God's invitation to you. Yeah. Confirm it. Make sure that you want him. And that when you want him, he say, hey, thank you. Come here. His choice for you. Don't put it off. Do it right now. Do this and you'll have your life on a firm footing. That everything you do will make sense. There are often times that we may ask ourselves or even ask others to this matter as a follow-up question. How can I believe that God is using this for my good? You ever look at your situation and say, is God using this for my good? Or maybe not, when there are opportunities which sometimes are good. They're good. But all opportunities you already know ain't good, which sometimes it'll show us that I shouldn't have did that. You have to place your identity. You have to place your identity in what God says rather than what you say or people say. God's identity of me or God's identity of you is who he says I am, or it's who he says you are. You can't. I love Indie Irie's song. I'm not my hair. I'm not my skin. I'm the soul that lives within. Soul is your will, your emotions, your desires, your passions, your intellects. This is where you make your decisions and choices. Your soulish realm is where you make your will, your emotions, your passions, your desires, and your intellect. In your soulish realm is how and where you make your decisions and choices. Okay, so you got to be careful operating out of your soul versus operating out of your spirit. Because soul and spirit is two different things. I know. You got to rightly divide the word of God so you'll know soul and spirit is two different things. That's why they say heart and soul. That's not the same thing. Your heart is how you are being you, and your soul are the decisions and choices you make. Watch this, to tell your heart how you're going to live. So it doesn't happen without an invitation, that how you're setting yourself up has a lot to do with have God invited you to a place and you do not use the invitation. I am not what others say I am, or even who I say I am to this matter. God's word says his word will work good for my good. Did you hear what I said? God's word says that God's word will work good for my good. When we have an invitation from God, he only works good for our good. That's the only way God's invitation works. Come here, and I'm going to work all this stuff out. I'm going to work it good for your good. Often, we got to understand that when God is dismantling some things or not allowing some things, it's not necessarily that he's not working. He's working that thing for our good. He's working that good, not good thing, for our good. When I invite and keep his word for my good, it needs no invitation. Because I've already opened up to tell God, you know what? That's why I wrote, again, I share this often, your will. The second verse says, no rubies, no diamonds, no silver, no pearls. There are some lessons that I had to learn that I wouldn't trade in this world. My trials only come to make me strong. And with this, you promised never to leave me alone. But y'all, it took me years to write this song. There were some songs I wrote earlier that only grace created the moment in time to write your will. I had to give God time for me to write your will. Because prior to that, I just thought everything was supposed to go my way because it's the way to come sound to sort of people. You're supposed to have everything you want. That's not true. Sometimes what I want ain't good for me. And if you really look at it too, how many of y'all have gotten the wrong relationships? How many of y'all have done some things you wish you hadn't done? Yeah, those are some good things, but they weren't too good for you. So sometimes God's grace will allow us to understand that I'm going to put time on this thing. And I'm going to make sure you're ready for me. And when you open up and give me an invitation to come into you, it ain't going to happen without an invitation. He ain't going to bombard your place of space. When I'm not growing, I'm in a place of emptiness. When you are not growing, you're in a place of emptiness. Ain't nothing there. And one should never live like this. Here you cease to grow. Whenever you're in the place of emptiness and you can't see anything, you can't move, you can't do anything, you got to be careful there. Because it's a place of despair. It's a place where you can't grow, you can't move, you can't operate. And this place only turns into despair. It turns into you thinking, I can't do this, I can't do this, I can't go. Sunday, in one of our Sunday services, there was a young lady who would always sit in the front, and Wonderful told me, just pray for her. And she would just sit there and wouldn't move, and she was walking. And I got her up, and I said, I want you to stand up and walk. And she was almost like she couldn't do it. She stood up finally, and I said, you know what I want you to do? I want you to walk over to that guy, but I don't want you to walk. I want you to switch. And she said, oh, Pastor, I said, please, just do it. Just try it. Just try it. I gave her an invitation. And sometimes, if God gives us an invitation to do something uniquely different than we think we can do, you got to take the invitation. But it's only for our good. So she gets up and she walks and she switches all the way over there to him. The place started cracking up laughing. Gone. Now, when she came back, she reminded me of the person walking on the water. As long as they kept their eye on Jesus, they were cool. But the minute they stopped and said, oh, I'm walking on water, they started sinking. And that's what reminded me of her. When she started finding out she was doing it, she like, oh, and she started thinking about what she couldn't do. And I had to grab her. Listen to me, people of God. It doesn't happen without invitation. God has to be invited into your heart, your head, and into your life in order for what you see to be uniquely different in context of how he sees it. Because I haven't seen, either haven't heard, neither has it entered into the heart of man, the things he has prepared for us. And watch this. I'm about to close. Distance and time, if you're not careful, can be irrelevant to what God is doing. Yep. Distance and time can be totally irrelevant to what God is doing. When it comes to God, it's not necessarily about distance and time. That's why I gave you that illustration about grace. Because sometimes he says, according to your faith, be it unto you. When they was walking towards Jesus, their faith says, I could do this. But as soon as they saw the water, they fell. When she started walking towards Jesus' faith, I could she do it. As soon as she found out, wait a minute, is this me? She fell. So a lot of times you got to make sure the invitation that God brings to you, that you include all of the ups and downs, that at the end of the day, he has the whole story. God does exclamations, not explanations. He only does exclamations. He says, before my word fail, heaven and earth will pass away. So what he's doing in our lives, it doesn't happen without invitation. Every day, daily, he needs an invitation to be the person that guides and directs our promises. I must invite and keep peace. I must invite and keep love, respect. I must invite and keep the joy, which is God's word, the strength of my life. And I must and keep life, which is the foundation of the things I'm doing. You all, life is simply the basics. Life, God's perspective is simply the basics. Food, shelter, peace, love, real love, joy, that's life. And all these other things shall be added is the above and beyond. When God says life, he's not talking about what you want. When God is talking about life, he's simply sharing with you the things you need. God says, I'll supply all of your needs. And your needs cannot be met God's way. Cannot happen without an invitation. You could try your mother, your brother, your sister. You can even do your job. But God's way of your love, joy, peace, and life and more abundantly does not happen without invitation. He has to be invited into your space and place, and you have to invite him to lead and direct you. I must truly love me enough so that I may invite God's definition of me my way in my life. When you use invitation only, when it comes to God, you'll notice that the best opportunities and ideas are hidden right in front of you. Did you hear what I said? When you use God's invitations, More often than not, all of your opportunities and best ideas are right in front of you. It's how you see fixing this and doing this so that tomorrow can take care of itself. They're right near you, all of your answers in God's word, but you must be on the lookout for them. You can see 1,000 opportunities around you everywhere, every day. Watch this. And absolutely see nothing. You can't see God's way of doing things. It doesn't happen without an invitation. Hey, God, show me this. Show me this. Show me this. He says, thank you. Come here. Your big opportunity may be right where you are. Too many people spend their whole life devoted only to solving problems. You don't want to be that kind of person to, I'm sick of solving problems. Sometimes I'm sick of thinking for people. Sometimes, I'm telling you the truth, sometimes, Pastor, oh, it's just like everywhere I go, it's like somebody, yeah, and I love it, but there are times I need some peace. I need some getaways. And it only happens, it won't happen without an invitation. God, show me how to do this. Good, don't you overworking yourself. He's not going to invade your space and place. You ever went all week and worked and didn't invite God into that? Well, he told you, what you doing? Really? Yeah. You getting this? Your peace, love, joy, and life in there more abundantly will not happen. It doesn't happen without an invitation. You have to invite God into your space and place every day so that your journey can make sense. And not recognizing the invitation that God has already significantly given you, you're doomed to fail. Yeah. But when you recognize what God has for you, he says this. So friends, confirm the invitation to you, his choice for you. Don't put it off. Do it now. Do this, and you'll have your life on a firm footing. Watch this. Go to the scripture. Watch this. Of which salvation the prophets have inquired and searched diligently. Yeah. Are you searching to invite him as an invitation into everything you're doing? Of which salvation the prophets have inquired and searched diligently. Searched. Who prophesied of the grace God has given me time that I should come unto you. Or if you work God's word and you want him in here, you say, God, come to me. And he will. And once you ask God to come to you, he then says, thank you. I receive you. Come on, let's do this. Whatever's going on in your heart, in your head, or in your life, if it's going to be God's way, it does not happen without an invitation. You have to invite God always into your space and place. Ain't that crazy amazing? Let us pray. Lord, we love you. We give you honor. We give you glory. Thank you for all of your promises. We're going to put every area of our lives in your hands, not religiously, but because we know without a shadow of doubt that you know the end before the beginning. And some of us can live our whole lives without you if that's our choice. But you also says, my sheep know my voice, and a strange voice or anything other than my word, they will not follow. This is our place of understanding that nothing we can do that you have planned for our lives can happen without us inviting you into our hearts. We're clear. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. All right, let's do our actions. Did you enjoy that? Yes, sir. It doesn't happen without invitation. You could do a lot of things without God. You better heard me. You better heard me. All right, here go three. These are good ones right here. Put them on your refrigerator. Put them where you frequent. When I want to be powerful, I face the fear that confronts me. That controls me. When I want to be powerful, I face the fear that controls me. Sometimes life want to make you do things without God. That's a fear that controls you. Mm-mm. When you want to be powerful, you face that fear and say, nope, I'm using God's word. Here's two. My tomorrow will only be what I do my best with today. You better hear me. Yep. Don't be trying to think tomorrow going to be better when you're not setting it up by what your actions are doing today. Here's three. What's difficult to me is what fuels me to overcome it. Mm-hmm. What seems impossible, God's word tells me not what to do, but how to do it. And one of the ways I can do it is to understand I cannot make it happen without an invitation of God coming into my space and place always. Yep. Lord, we love you. We give you honor. We give you glory. Thank you for this word that it only happens with invitation. Every time we're doing something, you says in all of our ways to acknowledge you, and you will direct our path. I thank you for a way out of no way. I thank you for being a rock in the weary land. I thank you for being a shelter in a time of storm. I thank you for changing my past into a gift of the present. And Lord, who knows what tomorrow holds, but I do know as long as I keep you as an invitation to lead and guide me, I can only anticipate your promises of yea and amen. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. All right. Here are ways to give. If this message has blessed you, oh my goodness. Yeah, thank you. Email us, let us know, Pastor, you really giving me some insight with this stuff. You can Zelle us, Grace Central Church. You can do credit or debit, online giving. You can send check or money order to 10216 South Kitchener Street, Westchester, Illinois. You can also do Cash App, $ Grace Central Church. You can call us, 708-344-5020, and we'll send somebody to get it, or either send an Uber to get you, bring it yourself so you can come to church. Ain't that crazy amazing? Yes. All right. We look forward to seeing you. Great Central Church. Come visit us on Sundays. 10216 South Kitchener Street, Westchester, Illinois. Sunday morning worship, 10:30 till noon. I say till noon because it's better to have a star and not reach for it than not to have a star at all. We come here 10:30 to noon. If God's presence show up, it's his presence. It's not us, but we do have a star in place. It's kind of sort of like going to a party and it's supposed to be over, but then when things start happening, we crumble. Yeah, it's kind of sort of like that. But it's better to have the basics set up and then let God's crazy, amazing invitation take us to another place, all right? We love you so much. If you come visit us on Sunday morning, you'll have a wonderful experience, great information, a great song, the whole nine. And, of course, on Tuesday nights, we celebrate just like they do anniversaries and birthdays by drinking. I have a few good reasons for drinking, and one has just entered my head. If a man can't drink while he's living, how can he drink when he's dead? That's the other song I wrote about some other kind of stuff, but we don't drink that kind of drink. Well, not in church. We drink the apple cider drink to celebrate the word of God, okay? And today we're drinking too. It doesn't happen. Whatever you want from God without an invitation. Cheers.